We got to introduce this to Earl, Eddie Holstein.
And the first place I wanted to go was in May. deep. Anton made me a hamburger. And I really hadn't met Earl before. Freddie was working for him, but he had a nickname called Phantom. It wasn't around that much. Or Disappearo. So I'm sitting at the bar, and all of a sudden my beer stein starts to rattle. Candles go out. There's an ill wind that comes through the house. The door opens, and there he is, the great one. First thing he did as he walked through the door is he went to the public phone to see if anybody left change. Boy, in this age of cell phones, it must be killing you now. And he was immaculate looking. He looked like he just got a haircut. He was clean shaven and he had a suit on. And the first thing I thought when I saw that suit, I thought Robert Hall went out of business. And he had a tap collar shirt way past the style when he went out of style like 5 years ago. I heard a rumor later on that he got his suits from Leukemia's funeral parlor. But he always blamed Vito, his partner. He said, that's where we got those suits. Vito used to get his suits. After years of thinking about it, I realized I never saw Vito in a suit. He came to the bar and Gus introduced us. He said, you know, this is Fred's younger brother. I also remember the first time Earl took me out to dinner with Joey. And we went to the Prime House. And Earl picked up the check. And I thought, this is good. And I realized Earl didn't like to eat alone. So I always made myself available. We were strange kind of folkies. Well, I was going into the Hoots and Earl would come by and every once in a while listen for a little bit, but I wasn't getting a gig. Then came the Democratic National Convention and Earl came up to me and said, kid, I'm going to give you a couple nights. It was during the Democratic National Convention. There was the National Guard, where Norwell Drugs used to be. There were policemen running down the streets with guns and clubs, and Earl said, I'm going to give you a couple nights. I got to tell you, though, I was excited. It was my first night in show business in the Earl of Old Town. Brooks Brothers shirt and slacks, and I was doing this song at the Earl of Old Town. There was 20 people there, but I was so excited. As I was playing this song, I looked over where you are, and I noticed it was Vincent Price. See, the Earl of Old Town had an interesting group of luminaries that came there, like in some clubs on the south, on the west coast or the east coast, you have people like Allen Ginsberg coming in, or Hunter Thompson, William Burroughs. We had Hugh O'Brien, Pernell Roberts. Anybody who was doing dinner theater came to the revolt. But I was so impressed. I'm sitting here, Vincent Price. and he's sitting there French kissing this young woman, and I'm playing this little guitar part, trying not to look. I thought, this is pretty good for my first night in show business. I also wondered if that woman ever saw the movie House of Wax. Hear Vincent Price say to her, he's talking quietly, that's how he's playing his guitar part. He said, he's pretty good, isn't he? He said, I'm enjoying him. He said, you know, I'm staying at the Water Tower Hotel on Chicago Avenue, and they gave me a portable phonograph record player, and I've got all of his records. And they left. Now you can't make that up. Only in the Earl of Old Town would that happen. That didn't happen at the guests like New York or the Coffee Gallery in San Francisco. That happened in the Earl of Old Town. Many years later, I was auditioning for some young guy at some club, and I was singing Don't Think Twice, it's all right. He said to me, it was a nice set, that song, Don't Think Twice, it's a great song. I said, sure is. He said, is that one of yours? He said, yeah. He said, do you have any others? I sang him 100 songs. The one about blowing the wind brought him to tears.